What's happening, guys? As you have noticed, we have left the PU land for a while and entered Andarius territory to try our skills with a bit more serious team on a much more demanding playground. Yes, we are ambitious, competitive, we are here to win. Until, of course, we stumble across House of Wolves 100, then it's back to the regular, don't try too hard and just have fun mode. Or is it? Not today, ladies and gentlemen. Today, Mark is giving it his best shot too. He has also brought a serious Aura's OU team, and unlike mine, there is definitely a Mega on his team, and no matter if it's a Sceptile, Alakazam or Metagross, I need to play carefully around it, as my single mistake could cost me a very high price. Other than that, I need to figure out how to break through his Milotic, because I don't have anything that directly threatens it, and it has the advantage against 3 of my pokes. Alright, enough introduction, let's see how it went down. I lead off with Hippowdon, not only to set up my Sand, but also because it threatens his Klefki, which I knew for a fact is gonna be his lead. I set up my Stealth Rock as he switches to Sceptile, and this thing is probably the biggest threat to my team. Look at that, specially defensive Empoleon, my only answer to it took nearly half from Leaf Storm. Next time this thing comes in, Polarity is not stopping it. But we will cross that bridge when we get to it. Right now, he switches to Klefki, and I have faced this thing enough times by now to know that either a Thunder Wave or a Toxic is coming my way, so I switch to the only thing that doesn't care about neither, Reuniclus. Then I figure that since Empoleon is carrying Defog, I might as well let him set up some hazards and use that turn to set up a Calm Mind to put a pressure on him. Knowing that he is not going to stay in and let me set up freely, I follow it up with a Psyshock and do a very good chunk to his Alakazam on the switch. I know that the only reason he will bring this thing in is if he has a Shadow Ball, so I make an aggressive, risky play and switch to my Stoutland to sponge it and Pursuit Trap him for an easy KO. That's one threat out of the way. Now he brings his Metagross, and knowing that Empoleon won't be stopping Sceptile anyway, I decide to switch to it and find out if he's carrying an Earthquake. He sets up a Houndclaw on my switch, but then, to my relief, reveals that Zen Headbutt is the best move he has to hit me with, but I take it relatively well and roar him out of there. I drag out his Talonflame and take half of its delicious HP on the switch, but in return, he takes my Empoleon out of a Flare Blitz. Now I go back to Hippowdon, knowing that it can easily sponge another one of these, and go for an Earthquake, thinking that he might want to save this thing as a death fodder, but he decides just to leave it in, and it pays off, as he gets a crit on the following turn, but thankfully, Hippo is bulky enough to leave it, and I recover most of the damage taken with a Slack Off as he goes down to the recoil damage. Now though, back comes the threat. Empoleon is dead, what am I supposed to do? Reuniclus, can you? Oh, that's his Mega. Nope, you can't. So at this point, I realize that offense is my best defense, so I go right to my Phantom and go for a return, hoping that he will stay in predicting my pursuit. And he does. It really was 50-50 chance. If he had switched out right there, this thing could have done some serious damage to my team later on. But he didn't. It's dead, and that's all that matters. Now, we only have to figure out how to break through his Milotic, and we're golden. Hippo can take care of the rest. Sludge Wave from Nidoking is clearly not cutting it, especially that 12 of his 3 remaining pokes are immune to it. So I figure that Gigalith is my best bet, especially that he has no idea about its set, but I decide to wear down his pokes a bit more before I reveal it. For that, I switch to Hippowdon, but he immediately goes back to Milotic seeing it, and although I am carrying Toxic, the last thing I want is to give him a Marvel Scale boost, so I go for an Earthquake instead and get a random crit, which makes as much difference as Talonflame's earlier crit, he just recovers it on the next turn. So I decide to get off the last Earth power and let my Nidoking die to get a safe switch to Stoutland, trying to hit it with all I've got. He knows, however, that he needs his Milotic in order to have any chance of winning this game and switches back to Klefki to sponge it, but you know what? I'm getting tired of this thing coming in like it's no big deal. I'm tired of the stall. Gigalith, it's time. Yep, it's here. What you gonna do? That Slash Cannon did nothing. Get up out. Who is next? Milotic? You think that just because of a special defense drop I'm going to switch out? Incorrect! Get up out! And just to rub salt in his wound, right after his Metagross misses a Meteor Mash, but then you realize that Meteor Mash has the same chance of missing as Slash Cannon to drop special defense, so I would say that's fair. And even if he wouldn't miss, Hippowdon can easily stall this thing out and 2-hit KO it from this range with an Earthquake, so one way or another, that is the game. Good game, Mark. That even up to the point where my Gigalith decided to come in and finish it real quick, but that's the reason why it's on the team. Once again, it proved itself worthy of its place. I know you guys enjoyed this battle, don't tell me you didn't, so don't forget to rate and comment the video, especially comment, your feedback really means a lot to me, and as always, I see all of you next time.